Hey guys, what's up? I'm back, and this week I'm drawing something spooky for Halloween. It's original content. Like many artists who got into comics or animation or other related fields, I've got quite a few of my own stories and characters, and one of my stories is quite fitting for this time of year because it's on the creepier side. So recently I was watching playthroughs of Silent Hill PT for nostalgia's sake. Rip Silent Hills, you would have been an amazing horror game. Can I get an F in the chat? If you haven't watched Silent Hill PT and you like psychological horror, you should watch it. One of the most surreal, nightmarish games ever. Because of this, I decided to look up what exactly the Silent Hill lore actually was, because all I knew was spooky town filled with horrible monsters. And what I found was pretty interesting. See, the story this illustration is from has a particular setting. A small town that every night will cross over with another plane of existence that draws from the psyches of those in it. And then I read the bare bones premise of Silent Hill's setting, which is a small town that at random intervals will cross over with another plane of existence that draws from the psyches of those in it. And I was like, dude, that's super cool. Proof that nothing you make will ever be truly original. I'm sure there are lots of other similar stories out there. Obviously, the details of these stories are very different, but I think it's pretty cool that the basic setting I came up with was so similar to that of Silent Hill, without even me knowing. I know some artists get upset when people compare their stories or characters to stuff they've seen before, but I personally think it's pretty cool. The characters here are named April and Eddie. April, the human, is a newcomer to the town. Her family moved here only recently, and she's one of the only people who was actually transported to this other dimension at night. She calls it the Ether. The Bat, which is Eddie, has been trapped in the Ether since 1997 and is the soul of Edward Cecil, a serial killer, manifested as a bat. Fun fact? Eddie's last name comes from the Cecil Hotel, which is a real place in California that's sort of infamous. If you've heard of the murder of Eliza Lamb, that was at the Cecil Hotel, but even before then, it was known for quite a few deaths that took place there, and it even unwittingly took in serial killers as guests twice. They changed their name recently due to their infamy. Oof. In this drawing, Eddie and April are hiding in the Blockbuster that Cecil used to work at when he was alive, which is still around in the Ether's version of the town. I've had a lot of fun finding the aesthetic for the Ether because it tends to change depending on whose psyche it's pulling from. When the world is primarily drawing from April's subconscious, it takes on a more sepia or black and white look, and it has lots of shadowy silhouettes and strange figures. This is partly because April happens to suffer from schizophrenia, and this world is largely drawing from the way her mind is affected by her symptoms. By contrast, when the world is drawing from Eddie's subconscious, it takes on a more neon 80s type aesthetic, because Eddie is a big fan of horror films, particularly those from the 80s. Since the Blockbuster they're in is taken from Eddie's memory, it's currently taking on that latter aesthetic. Maybe later this month I'll do a second illustration of them with the first aesthetic. As for the monster, well, in Silent Hill-ish fashion, the monsters here are physical manifestations of people's anxieties, fears, and trauma. That made this pretty difficult for me because I'm not used to this kind of creature design. But I'm pretty proud considering this was my first time ever designing something like this. In this case, it's once again drawn from Eddie's psyche. When Eddie worked the graveyard shift here, he had two co-workers who became his good friends. When he turned himself in for his crimes, yeah, he turned himself in, make of that what you will, and the news started reporting that the killer had been caught, his friends assumed that the police had wrongly accused Eddie and went all the way down to the station to insist that they had the wrong person. Because Eddie was just some guy who worked at Blockbuster. He couldn't even kill someone if he wanted to, right? Once they realized that Eddie had turned himself in and was actually the killer, they were understandably horrified, and that unpleasant memory is burned in Eddie's brain quite vividly. Again, make of that what you will. Because of the memory's nature, I wanted to make it look like the monster was in physical pain. I gave it bloody fangs, a common motif with Edward because his serial killer nickname was the Vampire of Echo Grove. But then I realized that I could make it look like the fangs were also spearing upward through the creature's two heads, so I did that. The spikes on its back are metal shrapnel, piercing through the skin from inside. I recently finished fleshing out the summary of this story, and I like it a lot. It's inspired by a lot of things I like. Games like Limbo, PT, and Outlast, shows like Gravity Falls and Over the Garden Wall, and movies like It Follows. I'm even playing remixes of the It Follows soundtrack under my voice, as well as the true crime podcasts and YouTubers I listen to. I'm definitely excited to draw this as a comic. Maybe soon? I've been wanting to do a webcomic of some sort since high school, and I'm glad I waited until I was done at SCAD, my art school, because I improved a ton in those 4 years. Now it's just a matter of settling on a project and sticking with it. I'm sure any other artists watching can relate. Speaking of other artists, when I do finally start work on a webcomic, let me know if you'd be interested in vlogs about it. I'm sure at least some of the people who enjoy my content are artists themselves, which is, quite frankly, awesome. These vlogs could also maybe double as tutorials. Someone commented on my last video that I should make a tutorial. There's so much that I could talk about, but if any of you guys have anything specific you'd like to hear about, go ahead and give me suggestions in the comments, and tell me what your favorite horror games are. I haven't watched a playthrough of a horror game lately, at least not one that I haven't watched before. I hope you guys liked this not fan art. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Later! Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul and seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder.